Hello dear students, I am back with the next part of the chapter, that is sexual reproduction in flowering plant of class 12. Okay, so before lecture we have seen something regarding structure of stamens, microsporangia and pollen grains we were seeing with. Okay, so in that particular those particular thing we have seen something regarding pollen grains, and we have seen regarding the types or layers that are present in pollen grains. We have seen with axine and intine. Axine was called as outermost layer, intine means innermost layer. Okay, then on we have seen with the four walled layer. Okay, the four walled layer that are present in microsporangia, which were epidermis, endothecium, then middle layer, and the last innermost layer, that was tapetum. So those three layers, the top, that is epithelium, endothecium and middle layer, they are involved in giving protection. Okay, they were giving protection to the sac like structure, that was pollen sac, which was consisting fully packed with the pollen grains. Okay, then regarding tapetum, we have seen that tapetum has main function, that is it is having what? Nourishment function. It nourishes the pollen sac and also the pollen grain in it. Okay, now we'll again start with the axine part, axine and intine. Okay, outermost layer, outermost and inner layer. Okay, so first we'll start with again axine. Okay, so axine is made up of sporopollenin. Okay, it is made up of sporopollenin, outermost layer, and it is said that this particular layer of pollen grain is resistant. They are resistant to temperature and humidity. Okay, they have more resistant power to the climatic changes that occurs. Then it is also said that no enzymatic activity, okay, no enzymatic activity is involved in destroying this particular layer, that is axine. Okay, now we'll see with intine, that is innermost layer. It is said that this innermost layer is made up of cellulose and pectin. Okay, this particular two layer, they are the innermost layer which helps in nourishment. Okay, nourished part of pollen grain. Okay, further on, when this pollen grain matures, I have told you the maturation of pollen grain occurs when dehiscence process. Okay, we have seen in the previous lecture, that is dehiscence was what? Dehiscence means it is splitting off upon maturity. Okay, once the line the pollen grains splits or it move on from the pollen sac, jab wo pollen sac se bahar nikalte hain during line of dehiscence process, then upon maturation only those things happen. Okay, so upon maturation it forms two layer or two type of cell is formed. First is vegetative cell and second is generative cell. These two types of cell are formed upon maturation of a pollen grain. Now we'll see with each, that is vegetative and generative cells, in detail. Now we'll study this in comparison part only. Comparatively we study with vegetative and generative cell. Okay, vegetative cell as well as generative cells. Now, vegetative cell of a pollen grain are said to be larger in size, whereas the generative cell of a pollen grain are said to be smaller in size. Okay, plus it is also seen that, I'll draw the diagram also, vegetative cells are seen in irregular shape, okay, whereas the generative cell, they are having spindle shaped structure, or they are spindle shaped in structure. Okay, now we'll see with the maturation part of a pollen grain. This is how the diagram particularly looks, wherein two types of cells upon maturation are formed. This is vegetative and here it is spindle shape, irregular in structure. Okay, this is generative cell and it is vegetative and here it is generative cells with some type of deposition of sporopollenin as well as cellulose in it. It is said that generative cells, they float in a cytoplasm. Okay, their particular characteristics is there in generative cell. Okay, now regarding the structure of pollen grain, when experimentally we see, if you want to see with the structure of pollen grain, you might have observed in a flower. I would like to show you a flower, okay, wherein you can see over here, I have just got it from the garden. I would like to show you this. Now here you can see the diagram on, see, this is male part of a flower. Here you can see, I hope, is it visible to all? Now here you can see with, again I would like to say, see this particular part, you can see these are called, jo bahar ke side aapko latke dikh rahe hai, these are anthers. Okay, and the stalk like structure, the line, you can see the yellowish, lightish yellowish structure, this is called as filament and this is anther. Now if I rub this, aise main agar spin karu, rub karu apne haathon pe, then I will get a yellow color ka kuch powder stick hoga on my hand. That yellowing color powder, if you take on a slide, suppose if you take a slide aur mere haath mein jo yellow color ka jo powdery part tha, if I keep on this particular slide and observe under microscope with a drop of water on it, then you'll see the amazing structure of pollen grain, which are somewhat in round shape and this particular shape. ये आपको माइक्रोस्कोप में दिखेंगे विजिबली. ओके, यू कैन सी दिस. सो पॉलन ग्रेन्स व्हेन सीन ऑफ अ डिफरेंट फ्लावर, दे आर समवॉट द शेप एंड द कलर ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन डिफर्स इन ईच फ्लावर. ओके, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ थॉर्न लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, दे आर समवॉट राउंड ओनली, बट द थॉर्न लाइक स्ट्रक्चर यू विल ऑब्जर्व इन धतूरा. धतूरा का जो पॉलन ग्रेन होता है, आप देखे होंगे धतूरा का ऐसा कुछ लॉन्ग लाइक स्ट्रक्चर होता है, एंड दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट, इफ यू जस्ट टेक पाउडरी पार्ट ऑफ दिस पॉलन प्रेजेंट ऑन इट, देन ये पाउडर पार्ट का आपको सिर्फ स्लाइड में लेना है, एंड यू वंस यू ऑब्जर्व अंडर माइक्रोस्कोप यू विल गेट द स्ट्रक्चर, द डिफरेंट साइज एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पॉलन यू विल ऑब्जर्व. आपको कलरफुल दिखेगा, ओके, ऑफ पॉलन ग्रेन. सो दिस थिंग, this outermost part will be called as what? Exine, again, and innermost part will be called as intyne. Okay, and for hibiscus, hibiscus ka agar if you observe microscopically the pollen grain, then it is somewhat round in structure. Okay, aise aapko chote chote microscope, suppose ye microscopic field hai, this microscopic field will contain small pollen grains present in, and they are clearly visible under microscope. Practically if you do, it is more visible. Okay, So this was regarding structure of pollen grains. Now something regarding the uses and the disorder which are caused when pollen grains are touched. Kuch pollen grains aise hote hai ki when you touch it you have some type of disorder caused. Allergies ho jati hai kisi kisi flower ke if you touch the anther part of a flower. Okay, so it also, you can say allergic reactions or allergic reaction seen in a person when they touch the anther part of a flower. Okay, then next is regarding it is sometimes involved in causing diseases with some type of disorders. Okay, disorders in the sense respiratory tract mein disorder hota hai when someone touches this. Kisi ko allergies hoti hai ki wo chheekne lag jate hain once they touch this. Okay, sensitive people, you know. Then it has some type of uses. Pollen grain ka uses bhi hai. So pollen grain is used as a tablet. Okay, it is given in the form of tablet in western countries. Okay, in western countries it is been given in the form of tablets because it is this pollen grain are being nourished by what, many types of cell. There's a tapetum, I have told the main function of tapetum was what, it nourishes the pollen grain. So nutrients are mostly present in pollen grains. So as a nutrient supplement, okay, as a nutrient supplement the tablets of pollen grain are being given. Okay, next thing in this is regarding the storage part. Pollen grains are stored in pollen bank. This is reserve bank hota hai. Pollen grains are also being stored in liquid nitrogen and the temperature for it would be, I hope you're when while watching you would know this particular answer. Aap apne aap mein bologe ki haan liquid nitrogen ka temperature itna hota hai. So it is -196 degree Celsius. In at this particular temperature the pollen grains are being preserved for longer duration. Okay, for further study they are being preserved. So here we complete with the stamen, microsporangium and pollen grains, that is male part of a flower. Once these are being matured, then they travel with the help of what, they travel with the help of pollen tube. Okay, now we will see with the female part of a flower. Okay, in female part of a flower it consists of pistil. Now comes megasporangium, or it is also called as ovules or egg cell. Okay, in previously we have seen what regarding the male part of a flower. There we have seen that pollen grain at last, which was having upon maturation they were forming two types of cells, that was vegetative cell and a generative cell. Okay, once these cells were formed they were called as three cell stage. Okay, and only when vegetative cells were there then two cell stage was formed. Now pistil, megasporangium, ovule and or it is also called as egg cell. Here female gametophyte. Female gametophyte in the sense ovules. Okay, ovules that are being released from the ovary, they are called as female gametophyte. Whereas in male gametophyte we have seen that microspores, that is what pollen grains, were called as male gametophyte. Here ovules are called as female gametophyte. And certain terms we have seen with, I'll just tell you the overview of this. Okay, then we'll move on to the next part in detail. Megaspore, megasporangia, then megasporangium. This same term we have seen in female, sorry, male gametophyte. In place of megaspore, we have seen with microspore. यहाँ पे टर्म था microsporangia and here in female part of a flower we have seen it as megaspore. And here again megasporangium and there we have seen with microsporangium we have seen. Now the difference in micro and mega. Micro means small, mega means larger. So you can say that female is larger in what? Female part of a flower. Okay, आप देखोगे in parts also 3 and 2 or simply 1. This one was again subdivided. Usually 2 ही थे. Male part of a flower was consisting only stamen. वो बहुत छोटा है. Only anther and filament were there. But in female part of flower you can see it is having more number of parts. That is, what were those part of female part of a flower? It was comprising what? Stigma, style and ovary. Parts भी ज़्यादा है. So it is easier to remember कि female part of a flower आता है तो you have to remember it as megasporangium. Okay? So we'll start with pistil. Pistil means is also called as corolla or female part of flower which was consisting of 3 main parts, that is stigma, style and ovary. Okay, now we'll see with the stigma part. Stigma is a particular part present on the top. Yesterday in previous lectures, okay, previous lectures we have seen that stigma were present on the top. In this particular flower also, I think it is not having petals only, it has male part of flower is not present in it. So it will have, for further fertilization it will have pollination process, it will fertilize with the other part of a flower. Okay, here you can see at home, I hope all the students will, aap ghar pe aise karna, powdery part aapko dikhega of a anther. Abhi to mere haath mein chalk hai. Once your hands are clean, then you can see the powder, yellowish powder present, okay, which comprises what? Yellowish powder present, that is what? From pollens in the form of anther. Okay, so first we'll start again over here with the word stigma. Okay, so we have completely seen with what? The male part of a flower. Okay, for the next lecture we'll start with the female part of a flower. Thank you.